Say peace to cats who rock Mac knowledge, knowledges, street astrologists, light up the mic, guard knives, the spot joints, the character points, Corolla, Motorola, Hola, play it guard, he pack over the shoulder, chrome tanks, play it like Yanks, check the franchise, front on my guys, my enterprise, flash many lives, lapel on fakes like reflectors, he has sugar in his ear in his last crack career, we can can him, manhandle him, if you wanna run in his cribbo, get ditto, skate like a limo, and jet to the fly's estate, relate, take a break, break down the ape and then wait, drop it like Drake. Thugs, they be bowing and screwing. We canoeing, claim they doing the same shit we doing. Fuck the union, it's the same style. Where's the trainer boy? Jump the turnstile. On the alley, try to challenge guard for the new bounce. Especially that aluminum bat in the act. Relax, laid back, sell a grenade a day. It pays black. The Mac 10 flex, white cats like Windex. Index, finger be sore, busting these fly spread. The Wally can't count, crazily grins for five plans. Laying with my bitches and my mans and Lex lands. We losing them. Jet to the stash and now Jerusalem. Abusing them, rocking his jewels like we using them. Low pro. Star, seven thick waves, rock polar, roll with the older guard, build with the sun and the star.
All start realizing, medals, got that shit, better keep you vibing, the movies here tonight, we shot it, find it, but it was
just... Hey, what's up? My name is Kerry Getz, owner of Nocturnal Skate Shop in Philadelphia, PA. 18 years now I've been professional skateboarder, skating for 28 to 30 years, and body's definitely feeling the pain. Yeah, I had a lot of influences growing up. There was a lot of like skate videos out there, Pal Peralta videos. Tony Hawk was one of the guys, just like a vert skater. I wasn't really a vert skater, but he always inspired me by just the mini ramp stuff that he did mixed with the vert stuff. And Eric Cosson was a huge guy, huge favorite of mine, because you know, he did the street skating like I grew up skating, and you know, he was always in the videos, pro shoes and all that stuff. So it's been really great to like watch those guys and watch them evolve into these like big time pros riding for big companies and stuff like that. So yeah, my main guy is probably Eric Cosson. I mean, a lot of people just see like the video clips where everybody's landing stuff, but it's like, you know, some of those tricks might have taken weeks to months to go back to this spot, because, you know, you get kicked out in 5-10 minutes and you drive an hour to try to film at one certain spot, and it's a constant battle to just get one trick that's going to go by in a video that's like 2 seconds long. So I mean, it is constantly a non-stop battle and dealing with cops and being chased from places. I mean, that's always been the hardest thing about filming and skating and street skating, is one of the hardest things to do, because your body takes the beating on the concrete and you're getting kicked out by security guards and cops all day long. So yeah, it's not the easiest job, I tell you. I mean, it looks easy when in the videos, but it definitely takes some time to film something like that. Sometimes it'll take a year to film, year to 2 years to film a great video part. Yeah, I mean, I've been up to pretty much the same stuff I've always been into, is just like taking care of the Philadelphia skate scene with Nocturnal Skate Shop. I've always, you know, wanted to make sure that there was a good shop that kids could come in and get all the hottest new products and, you know, just feel free to hang out, watch a video or something like that, and just have a good vibe, you know, and that's really what I really focus on. And then, you know, I got a whole team for the skate shop as well. Some of the guys are skating here, like Kevin Taylor and Kyle Nicholson. And, you know, Kyle Nicholson's 22, 23 right now, and he, you know, he's coming up in the skate industry big time. So keep your eye out for him, man. He's a killer. He destroys everything in his path. Yeah, but the dudes that really, you know, stick out to me is this guy, Dylan Sourbeer. He's a local guy right now that's really putting some great video parts out there and some great coverage. And my favorite, though, is Kyle Nicholson, because he can skate everything. He has a blast no matter what you put in front of him. And he's always got a smile on his face, never complains, just gets on his board and kills it. So Kyle and Dylan are two of my solid dudes that I see coming up in the skate industry. I mean, skaters always get bad reps because, you know, we are skating on ledges, putting some grind marks, making them black from our wheels and the wax that we put on it. But it's like, we're really not out to hurt anybody or get in anybody's way. You know what I mean? We're definitely there to just film a trick, have a good time and leave. And, you know, there's always that bad, you know, video that might come out on the news where, you know, they only show the kid kicking the guy in the head, but they don't show the beginning of the scenario where, you know, this dude might have laid his hands on this kid, or he might have choked him up, or he might have pushed him, or threw his board in the water or something. You never know the whole scenario unless you were there living it, you know? So I think skaters always get a bad rap, but I mean, I'm not saying all skaters are good, but I'm just saying, like, there are some bad kids out there, but there's bad kids in everything, football, baseball, no matter what, that want to start fights and want to do things. But I mean, you can't just all pin it on just skateboarding and skateboarders themselves. Well, when I was coming up in the skate scene around the 1997 to about 2007 was really the highlights of Philadelphia for myself and for skateboarding. I think in Philadelphia, it was the prime place to be. You could still skate Love Park. Josh Kalis, Stevie Williams, all these guys were filming there. Brian Wenning, they were putting out video parts after video parts of just Love Park footage and City Hall stuff. So it was like, it was the time, the early 2000s, when it was the prime for Philadelphia. And, you know, a lot of those guys moved away, and to me, it looked like it kind of faded away. But there's always a new group of kids, and there's always hungry kids out there that want to do the things that Josh Kalis did, the things that Stevie Williams did. So, I mean, it never ends. It just has its ups and downs, you know, like anything else. It's like a couple years it's up, a couple years it's down. But it always returns, and there's always those kids out there starving to get noticed and land some amazing stuff on a skateboard. Yeah, skateboarding, I mean, for myself, you know, I'll tell you, for myself, it kept me out of trouble, always. You know, like, there for a while when I was younger, I kind of got away from skating, hanging out with the wrong crowd, and my mom was like, you know, now you're getting in trouble, you're doing this. Like, I used to love it when you skateboarded, like, you were always just focused on that. You weren't getting in trouble, you were focused on skating, and that's all you wanted to do. I want to support you skateboarding, but if you're hanging out with these kids, I'm not going to help you out. Like, get, you know, like, at the time I was looking to get a new car, my mom's like, I will co-sign for you if you stop hanging out with these kids and get back on your board and just focus on this and stay away from the bad kids and be focused. So, I mean, for me, it absolutely changed my life. You know, it kept me on track, and I think it's a good thing to do. And another thing, you know, like Philly now putting up a skate plaza, I think that's huge. And, you know, we waited 13, 14 years for that. But, I mean, it's here. And I thank Philadelphia every single day that they built that for the skaters, because it helped skateboarding come back to Philadelphia. And it's going to launch some great pros from that area. You know, it gives these kids places to go, a place to go all day long where they don't have to run from cops or stress of getting arrested or anything else. So it's like they can go to this plaza, skate all kinds of different obstacles all day long and without getting harassed, which is amazing. Anytime you're in the Philadelphia area and you cruise down South Street, you gotta stop at my store. We carry Nike, Adidas, America, all the top shoe brands, and tons of clothing, the latest and the greatest of, like, clothing brands. And plus, we have our own line of Nocturnal clothes and Nocturnal boards. You gotta check it out, man. Like, we got a little of everything in Nocturnal at 533 South Street, Philadelphia, PA. And you got to keep an eye on our skate team, too. We got a lot of heavy hitters out of the Philadelphia skate scene. Legendary Kevin Taylor has been on the team since day one. We got Kyle Nicholson. We got Dan Hedrick. We got Scott O'Rourke. We got Angel Acevedo from Westchester area. We got a lot of good guys, and we're actually adding a few guys over the next couple weeks. So keep your eye on the team and keep your eye on the shop. This is Kerry Getz of WaterIce.com, your scoop to everything in Philly.